Now I know what you're thinking. 2K is boring. 2K is getting boring to me. I'm not gonna lie to y'all. It's getting very boring to me. Now, as you can see by the gameplay in the background, we're on some 3v3 Pro-Am. Now, I'm not going to lie to y'all. 3v3 Pro-Am is probably the best thing that they could have put in this game, because it has given me new life to at least want to play the game more. Don't get me wrong, I run into some tryhards, run into some sweats, but you know what? I still enjoy myself in this environment. I have not had an internet connection issue since I've been in the 3v3 Pro-Am. Have not had an issue with it. But however, whenever I'm in the rec, whenever I'm in the park, whenever I'm in possibly anti-up, y'all, I run into the same issues. Prime example, how in the world do you lag in my court? I know I'm not the only one that has happened to. Lagging in my court. 2K never ceases to amaze me, man. But let me talk about 2K20, then we're going to talk about 2K as a whole here. Now, you see me cooking up, you know. But, you know, I will say this. I'm glad they took the behind the back out of the game. Like I said earlier, there was no way to stop the cheese, as in the spamming behind the back that took you from one side of the court to the other. There was no way to stop it. I wish that they, instead of them nerfing moves, I wish that they would bring an overpower move to stop that. To stop that overpower move. You know what I'm saying? Everybody wants to go for the meta. Everybody wants to go for the easiest way to do this, easiest way to do that. Don't get wrong. Excuse me, y'all. It's late. I'm sorry, but everybody wants to go with the easiest way to do things. Don't get me wrong, I know everybody wants to have fun, but not everybody wants to play a try hard either. You know, if everybody's doing the same thing, that gets rid of the uniqueness of what's available to you. Now, don't get me wrong, I would give 2K their props. Not every build is made the same, and I understand that, and I get that, and I like that about 2K. However, they are constantly getting rid of everything that is good about the game, or not about the game, but they're getting rid of everything that is good. You got a good jump shot? Let's nerf it. Oh yeah, you use this dribble move, this dribble package? Let's nerf it. Oh, you could do this with your player? Let's nerf. You know what I'm saying? Like they're nerfing everything to the point the game is not fun. You know, I can't really get on here unless I go in 3v3 program. I'm not really going to have fun. Unless I'm playing with my friends, maybe. Yeah, but other than that, I'm not having fun. Another thing, too. Now, I kind of go into some things that I saw Agent talk about, where he was talking about there's no point into my court. Which I completely understand. Because let's say you go in there, you're trying out your jump shot. Yeah, let's just say you go in there, you're trying out your jump shot. First off, you green and you're getting used to it, you're getting good. Yeah, okay, cool, but there's no latency in my court. Everywhere you play online, there is latency. Anti-up, the rec, Pro-Am, 3v3 Pro-Am, everything has latency. Why can't y'all set that? 2K is a billion-dollar company. I've seen it done in Tekken. I've seen it done in other games. Why can't you set the latency? Why can't you set the latency? And then here's my thing too. With fixing the game and how quickly they do it. First off, they've done it, you know, I don't know how many patches it's been. I maybe what, 3 or 4. If I'm wrong, y'all let me know in the comments. But 3 or 4, I'm gonna go 5 at the most. 5 patches, right? Here's my thing, y'all. Now I understand Kobe's memorial service was earlier today. But here's my question. Y'all saw how quickly they put, you know, the RIP Kobe thing in there. You didn't even need an update for that. Y'all see how quick that they took the RIP Kobe thing out? You didn't need an update for that. So here's my thing. If you're able to put things in the game that quickly, why can't you fix the game just as quick? Y'all, like, honestly, 2K, honestly, to me, they don't listen. They don't listen until people start trending on Twitter, or there's comments that trend on Twitter. They don't care. To me, I don't think they care. They don't care enough to want to really fix the game. You know, 2K20 could have been one of the best basketball games to come out. but it's not. Why? Because we're still dealing with problems that were in older 2Ks. We're still dealing with problems that have been in the game since the game came out that are still an issue. We're dealing with issues that you would think if they just put more money or more people at work. Like, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that they're not working that dev team to death. Don't get me wrong, I know they're working. Because I know, y'all, I know how to code, y'all, this stuff, it gets ridiculous. But here's another thing, too. When over half your game is copy and paste, I know you got a year to do it, but like I said, if 50% of your game is copy and paste, you know, it's looking bad for you. But in all honesty, man, I don't know what to say for 2K. I really don't, me personally. Because I don't know. I really just don't know, y'all. And the game is just, it's boring to me. It's had the same snow look. I understand it's winter, but I mean, the events don't start on time. That's another thing. The events don't start on time. Events are ending sooner than later with no, I mean, not sooner than later, sooner than they're supposed to, with no explanation on why they ended. I mean, oh, and here's another thing too that I just found out. Now, guys, you know, like I said, I've been bored with the game, so, you know, I try to recreate my interior force. Y'all go back and watch my best big man build on 2K20. Y'all go back and watch that to see what I'm referring to. But in that video, I was showing how I would recreate my interior force to make him better than what he is, you know, when I showed the video. I went on and remade the build, and I'm playing into my career, and one thing that I realized was my progression is going a lot slower. And then it dawned on me, they slowed it down again. In 2K19, they slowed down the progression of slashers. You used to get, I'm just throwing out a number, you used to get, like, let's say 2500, I know it wasn't this, but 2500 my points for posterizers. Then they lowered that to like 1800, or lowered it even more than that. You know, so you have to constantly, you know, they set a limit to it. Let's say you did 25 posterizers. They only count up to 20. So them 5 extra posterizers that you were attempting to do, thinking you were going to get more of my points, you didn't get because they didn't count. You know, they're setting limits and caps to everything. Don't get me wrong, it's boring, you know. Don't get me wrong, you play through the same story mode in my career to grind your badges, because you can't do anything without your badges. I don't know what to say for the game, man. It's boring. It really is. Unless it's 3v3 program. And the only reason, like I said, it's fun on 3v3 program, I've had the most fun just going up against 3 people. Even if they're good comp or not, I'm having fun. I can talk, you know, I could just have fun with 3v3 point. I don't know what it is. Like I said, it's a solid connection. Haven't had an issue with it. In the rec or the park, it varies. It varies, man. Oh, man. And I don't know what to say for 2K. I really don't. I really don't know what to say else for him. You know, I just kind of wanted to go on my little rant. You know, I'll leave the rest of the gameplay for you guys to enjoy. There's nothing else on my mind that I can think about that I want to talk about with 2K20. Other than it's the same things. It's the same things every year. Oh, hang on. This one more thing too. This for the people that play in my court when you want to play with your friends or whatever. Why does it take you 9 times to try to join in a my court? Like, it keeps taking you to your my court, but it don't take you to your friend's my court. What is the, like, I know that this has been an issue since what, 2K15, 16? We going on 4 years. We're going on a consistent path of being wrong here. Like, I don't know what is with 2K not fixing these things that are an issue every single year. There's an invisible glitch every single year. There's something, don't get me wrong, you're gonna have your overpower, you're gonna have your cheese moves, you know, you're gonna have that. That's fine, that's cool, that's gonna be in every game. Every game isn't perfect, but a lot of the things that 2K is getting wrong, other games are able to do with less of a budget. Less rain, I about to say rain, less name recognition, less money, a smaller development team. Like that's what I'm saying. That's why I don't really have an excuse for 2K. That's why I'm so dumbfounded by this. There are a lot of games that are getting right what 2K isn't getting right. I don't know what else to say for 2K. Like I said, the game is boring. There's a reason why. Oh, and another thing too. Please do not release a game that is not finished. Please do not. There are reasons why people wait an entire month or two to purchase a 2K game. Why? Because the game comes out unfinished. Or there's some bug or there is something that happens. It's every year. In the beginning of 2K19, players were getting deleted. In the beginning of 2K20, weren't people's players getting deleted as well? Oh, man. And then, there's an issue with everyone that every 2K. Like, I'll say when 2K19 first came out, I went to the park. Man, I couldn't even get the ball to court because people were able to steal the ball so easily. I mean, man. And then that wasn't even counting the lockdown epidemic that came out. Oh, man, 2K20. You got that behind-the-back cheese. Don't get me wrong. I understand a behind-the-back move should be an effective move. But like I said, there's nothing to stop it. When you have overpowered moves that you cannot stop, it's one thing for a game to be fun to have overpowered moves. Okay, cool. But it makes an even better game when you have things that can stop it, you know? I'll say, for example, you guys remember on Def Jam, even if a guy was faster than, like, Def Jam Fight for New York, I know you guys remember this. Now, this was a EA game that came about 2004, for those of you that don't know, Def Jam Fight for New York. You could have a player that is fast, and I mean fast. You could have a fighting style, you know, let's say you were a wrestler going up against a martial artist, you know, one of the fastest type of fighters on there. Okay, cool. Yeah, you can't necessarily fight them head up like you would like, but there were counters to people that are constantly on the offense. You could counter a move, you could block a move, you could run, roll, dodge, you can do whatever you needed to do in that game to give you the upper hand. Against that behind the back with the screen, you couldn't do it because he could spam it. And when you're covering that much ground, you couldn't do nothing about it. So like I said, man, I don't know what to say for 2K. I know this is kind of a long video of me ranting on, but I just wanted to put this out for y'all. I know I ain't been on here much, but hey, I got some things coming up. I'm going to let you guys know. Y'all be on the lookout, okay? But if you guys agree, like the video, subscribe. Until next time, man, it's Between 7-7, man. I'm out. Peace.